Book of Isaiah, that's in the Old Testament.
49, verse 16.
Isaiah 49, verse 16. Behold, I have graven thee upon the palms of my hand. Thy walls are continually before me. Behold, I have graven thee upon the palms of my hand. This is God speaking, by the way. Thy walls are continually before me. Father, we thank you because the entrance of your word given life. This morning I pray that you will speak to us, that we will hear you clearly. Anoint these lips of clay that I will declare your word as an oracle of God. Anoint every heart to receive your word. Anoint every ear to hear your word. Glorify Jesus through this word. And I pray that as your word goes forth, let it go forth in simplicity, in power, in accuracy. Let everyone under the sound of my voice be touched by the power of your spirit. Let there be healing, salvation, deliverance. Let there be miracles, and let chains be broken as your word is spoken. Confirm your word this morning, and we thank you because it is done. Holy Spirit, have your way. I yield my spirit unto you. I pray that I may decrease, that you might increase. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name we pray. And everybody says amen.
Amen.
I want to speak this morning on what I've called walls before the Father. Walls before the Father. We read the scriptures, Isaiah 49 verse 16. He says, behold, God is speaking here. He says, behold. Oh, this mic, respect yourself. He says, behold, I have graven thee upon the palms of my hands. And then he says, thy walls are continually before me. So what does it mean when God says that your walls are continually before him? What does it mean when God says, we understand when he says, I've graven thee in the palms of my head. In other words, that God is saying that I have tattooed you, your name, your image, you are tattooed in the palms of my hand. I have graven you. That means every time God lifts his hand to do anything, every time God does anything or wants to do anything, you are right before his hands. You are right before his palms because he has graven you. He has tattooed you, so to speak, on the palms of his hands. But then he said, thy walls are continually before me. So this morning, I want to look at three things that walls represent in the scripture. And these are three things that I want to apply to when God says that your walls are before me. That is what I want to interpret to mean, that is what is before the Lord. When God says that your walls are before me, he's talking about something going on in your life that represents a wall. He's talking about a situation that represents a wall. And that is what he's saying, that is before him continually. And the first thing I want to bring your attention to when you talk about walls, especially in the context of the scripture, number one, wall is a place of wailing and prayers. Wall is a place of wailing and prayers. If you look at Isaiah chapter 38, Isaiah 38, I'm going to read verse 1 and verse 3, Isaiah 38, verse 1 and verse 3. In those days, Hezekiah, sick unto death, he was sick unto death, and Isaiah the prophet, the son of Amos, came unto him and said unto him, thus saith the Lord, set thy house in order, for thou shalt die. Oh, I would love for God to send me a pre-information. I don't know about you, but I wish and I pray that God will send every one of us a pre-information when the time comes to say, hey, you know what? Set your house in order. Not just your biological house. It means also your life, your plans, your family, everything about you. Set your house in order, for you will surely die. Many people die unexpectedly. They are not really prepared. And the scripture says, prepare to meet your God. But when God gives you a pre-information, that even makes it easier. That now means that you have opportunity to prepare. So God sends Isaiah to him, and he says to him, set your house in order, for thou shalt surely die and not live. Verse 2. Remember, we are reading Isaiah 38. Verse 2. Then Hezekiah, now look at this. Remember, we are trying to get to what walls represent in the scriptures. And we are talking about the wall being a place of wailing and prayers. Verse 2, the Bible says, then Isaiah turned his face towards the wall and prayed unto the Lord. Verse 3, and he said, remember thou, O Lord, I beseech thee now, how I have walked before thee in truth and with a perfect heart, and I have done that which is good in thy sight. And Isaiah wept sore. As the word came to him, prepare, for you will surely die. Isaiah turned to the wall, and the wall became a place of prayer and a place of wailing. Isaiah turned to the wall, and he cried out to God. And the Bible said, and he wept sore. He cried and wept and said, God, I don't know where if he said, please don't kill me. I don't know if he said, please, I don't want to die. But he said to him, oh God, remember how I've walked with you. I have cried, I've done my best. I've served you with my heart, with a perfect heart. And he prayed and he wailed. So when God says thy walls are continually before me, he means that your prayers and your wailing are continually before me. I don't know the things that have driven you to the wall. I don't know the things that have made you to cry and to wail. The Lord says this morning, as you hear the sound of my voice, God is hearing those cries. God has heard your wailing. I declare to somebody, your prayers have come before God. Your tears have come before God. Your dwelling has come before God, because he says your walls are continually before me. That means the wall of wailing, the wall of tears, the wall where you pray, you turn to the wall. It could be the wall by your bed. As you face your bed, the wall by your bed, or in your room, in your living room, wherever it is, and you cry. Every time you shed tears, every time you cry unto the Lord hears them, and he says, that your walls are continually before me. Aren't you happy that God is taking note of your tears and your wailing and your prayers? Come on, say amen, somebody. Amen. Lift your hands and say, oh Lord. Oh, come on, say it like you mean it. Oh Lord, according to your word, remember my tears. Remember my prayers. Remember my wailings. For you said your walls are continually before me. The wall where I cry unto you. The wall where I cry unto you. Where I pray unto you. Where I pour my heart unto you. Every secret prayer. Every secret cry that I have cried unto you. Hear me, O God. Hezekiah wept so. This morning I weep from my heart. Hear me, O God. According to your word, remember me and answer me. I declare to you this morning, God will surely answer you. Some of you didn't believe it. I said, God will surely answer you for every cry you have cried, for every tears you have shed. You know, the Bible says that he bottles your tears in his bottles. Are they not in his presence? Every time we shed tears, the angels come and collect those tears and they bottle them, and it's in God's presence. There's a whole warehouse in heaven where the tears appear, where the tears are bottled. And they, apart from the fact that the scripture says it, there was a man of God who went on a tour to heaven. God took him to heaven, and then God showed him. The angel took him to this whole warehouse full of bottles, and then he says, these are the tears of the saint. That every time you shed tears, every time you pray and you cry, the angels collect the tears and they bottle them up. And then he said, the angel took one of the bottles of tears and brought out a scroll. As he poured that tears, the words begin to appear. That means that every tears that you shed in the place of prayer, in the place of brokenness of heart, and those tears represent words. Those tears represent prayers. Every time that God's angels pour those tears on the scroll, they put the prayers from your heart, the tears that emanate from the prayers and the thoughts and the agonies of your heart, they appear on the scroll, and they just present them before God. That's what God is saying. That your walls are continually before me. Your tears are before me. Oh, I've come to announce to somebody, and this is good news, that God has heard your tears. I said, God has answered your prayer, because he says your walls are continually. continually before me. Your walls where you cry, your ear you turn to cry and to weep so, and to weep so, and to also pray. They are before him. So, wall is a place of wailing and prayer. And you know the good news? When Hezekiah prayed, before Isaiah got back home, God sent him. He said, you know what? Go right back to King Hezekiah and tell him, I've had your prayers, I've had your tears, and I've added 15 more years to you. So Hezekiah single-handedly changed the hand of God, changed the plan of God. Even though God said to him, prepare, you will surely die. Because of his prayer and tears, God changed the verdict and gave him 15 more years. I prophesy this morning, God will change his verdict over your life. Even if there is something the enemy determined or planned against you, in the place of your prayer, in the place of your tears, as you face the world before the Father will make God change his plan. He will make him change his verdict. Something good will happen. I said something good will happen in your life. If you believe it, you should be saying a louder amen. Something good must happen before this year ends. As we enter year 2022, something good. Say to yourself, I believe that something good will happen to me. I believe before the end of this year, something good will happen to me. In year 2022, I believe something good will happen to me because my walls are continually before the Father. Amen. Number two, the walls in the scriptures. And in the context of this scripture, of this message, walls also represent a place of obstacle and limitations. Many times we face walls in our lives, and those walls are obstacles and limitations. So when God says your walls are continually before me, it means that those obstacles and limitations you face are continually before me. I want to read Joshua chapter 6. I'm going to read verse 1 to verse 5. The book of Joshua chapter 6 from verse 1 to 5. And we'll see a situation where the people of God had a promise. They were trying to go into to possess the promise. But there was a wall of obstacle. There was a wall of limitation. But God gave them the victory. Joshua chapter 6 verse 1 to verse 5. Now Jericho was strictly shut up. Now they were to go possess the land. Remember, they were in process, in progress. They were in transit, trying to go enter the promised land of Canaan. But there was this wall of Jericho, which represented a wall of limitation, a wall of obstacles, a wall of barrier that was standing before them. And the Bible says that now Jericho was straight shut up because of the children of Israel. None went out and none came in. Before we had lockdown that we had last year, there have been lockdown way hundreds of thousands of years ago. So the whole city of Jericho was on lockdown because of the children of Israel. Nobody went out, nobody came in because they didn't want them to pass through their city to go to the promised land. So that became an obstacle and limitation the people of God faced. But look at verse 2. And the Lord said to Joshua, see, I have given thee into thy hand Jericho and the king thereof and the mighty men thereof. Have we not taught you that God does not operate by what you see? God was talking to them about a hopeless situation. God was talking to them about a situation that constitutes limitation and obstacles. There was nowhere to go through Jericho. The road was blocked. The wall was high. The gates were locked and everywhere was fence. And God said to them, I have given you Jericho. Hey, God, wait a minute. You are talking about Jericho with the very high fence. It is said about the wall of Jericho that 6 horses and chariots can travel side by side with it, on it. That means it's so wide that 6 horses can ride on it. And yet God says, no matter the obstacle, no matter the limitation, no matter how great the wall looks, I have given you Jericho. And I sense that's what God is saying this morning. When God tells us that His wall, our walls are before Him, the wall of opposition and the walls of limitation, it doesn't matter the limitations you are facing. God is saying to you, I have given you that limitation. Whatever it is that has brought limitations your way, God has given you the victory already. I said He has given you victory already. Don't look at the walls you see. Don't look at what you see with your physical eye, because God has given the victory. And look at what He said to them. Verse 3. And you shall encompass. You shall encompass the city of all the men of war. Go round about the city once. Thou shalt do this 6 days. And on the seventh day, verse 4. And on the seventh day, the seventh priest shall bear the ark, 7 trumpets of ram, ram's horns. And the 7 days you shall compass the city 7 times. On the 7th day you shall compass the city 7 times. And the priest shall blow the horn with the trumpets. Verse 5. And it shall come to pass that when they make a long blast with the ram's song, and when they hear the sound of the trumpet, all the people shall shout with a great shout. And the wall of the city shall fall down flat. Amen. And the people shall ascend up every man straight before him.
Amen.
God is a master strategist.
Amen.
God can give you a strategy to bring down the battle. Can you imagine how they were going to pull down the wall of Jericho? There was no weapon, no bomb, no missile, no screwed missile, none of the weapons we have today. God gave them a simple instruction. As great as that wall is, don't look at the greatness of that wall. Just obey divine instruction. God said to them, march around the city every day, just once. Or every day, march around it once. Day 1, day 2, day 3, day 4, day 5, day 6. Then on the 7th day, march round about it 7 times. And on the 7th time, blow the trumpet, blow the horns, and let everybody shout a shout of victory. Woo! Praise the Lord! Glory! And as you shout, and as the trumpet blows, the angels of God are going to go into action. The word of God is going to be activated, and the wall will fall flat. And that was exactly what happened. On the 7th day, as they blow the trumpet, and they shouted for the joy of the victory God was going to give them, that wall came crumbling down. I've come to announce to somebody, as you shout a shout of joy, as you shout unto the Lord, God will give you the victory. It doesn't matter the obstacle before you. It doesn't matter the limitation before you. God says your walls are continually before me. That means that the walls of obstacle, the walls of limitation, the walls of barrier that hinders you from entering your destiny, that hinders you from fulfilling your goals, those walls are before God. And He's giving you the same instruction. Don't look at the greatness of the wall. Don't look at your obstacle. Don't be carried away by what you see. Look at the greatness of God. Believe God for the miracle. Believe the promises of God. Look beyond it, because God has given you the victory. And begin to shout for victory. Shout for joy. Blow the trumpet. Glory to God. Come on, lift your hand and shout and say, praise the Lord. Come on, praise the Lord. For every barrier that you face, for every limitation you face, for every wall of obstacle, come on, stand on your feet now, just like the Israelite did, and begin to praise God. Begin to thank Him that the wall has fallen. Thank Him in advance now that the wall is falling. Bless Him now. Father, we praise You for the wall of limitation is crumbling down. The wall of obstacles is crumbling down. Come on, praise Him. Praise Him. Open your mouth and praise Him. Give Him thanks. Shout for victory. Lord, we praise You. We thank You because the wall is falling flat. The mountain is falling flat. The wall of barrier, the wall of obstacles, the wall of limitation, whatever they are in our health, in our lives, in our finances, Father, we thank You. Just like the wall of Jericho fell, I declare this morning, that wall is coming down. Pray in the spirit for 1 minute. Pray in the spirit because the wall is coming down. Baba satata, Rebecca Boshede, Rabo Baba Sataya. Lord, you said the wall of limitation, the wall of obstacle is good before you. Therefore, we receive the instruction. And we thank you this morning. We thank you this morning because the wall is falling down. The wall is crumbling. The wall of ill health is crumbling. The wall of sickness and disease is crumbling. The wall of poverty is crumbling. The wall of lack is crumbling. The wall of death is crumbling. The wall of obstacle is crumbling. The wall of limitation is crumbling. The wall of joblessness is crumbling. Mababa sandabaya. Make a bosha tatata. Rabova posototo. Rebecca boshandabaya. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
In Jesus' name we declare. Therefore, as we have declared, I declare that by the Spirit of God, by the anointing of God, every wall of obstacle, every wall of limitation, every wall of stagnation, every wall of hindrance before you have crumbled now. I command and declare those walls have crumbled now. Walk through to your miracle. Walk through to your breakthrough. Possess your possession. I prophesy over you from this morning. Move on. Go on. Possess your possession. Don't stand there anymore. Don't just stand by the wall and watch, because God has given you the wall. He has given you the victory. Possess your possession. Go in and possess the possession, because the wall of Jericho in your life has come crumbling down. And so is it. In Jesus' name, amen. Have your seat. And as I round up, number 3. Wall is also a place of uncompleted projects or works. Did you hear that? Walls also represent a place of uncompleted projects or walls or works. Now, listen to this. Not just is it a place of uncompleted projects, but the kind that make people mock you. There are projects and works that become uncompleted in your life that make you become an object of ridicule, that makes people to begin to mock you. So when God says your walls are continually before me, that means that that project and that work and that thing that you have tried to accomplish that has never gotten accomplished, that has made you an obstacle, that has made you an object of mockery, an object of laughter, God is saying, I am watching over you. That wall is before me and I'm doing something about it. Say amen, somebody. Finally, I want to read Nehemiah, the book of Nehemiah chapter 4, verse 1 to 6. Nehemiah chapter 4, verse 1 to 6. Look at this. This was when the Israelites came back from captivity, and they were trying to rebuild the walls of Jerusalem. They were trying to rebuild the city, and there were people that didn't believe in them, and they mocked them, and they made caricature of them. So the wall in their context represents walls of unaccomplished or uncompleted projects, because that project had gone on for a long time. And the enemy mocked them and laughed at them and said, look at them, they can never complete it. They became an object of mockery. Nehemiah chapter 4, verse 1 to 6. But it came to pass that when Sanballat heard that, and Sanballat represents the enemy of God's people, when he heard that we builded the wall, he was wroth. In other words, he was annoyed. He was angry. And he took great indignation and mocked the Jews. The devil is still doing the same thing. Every time you want to do something in fulfillment of God's promise over your life, the enemy will get angry. He's going to throw stones at you. He's going to mock you. And then the enemy, he mocked the Jews. Verse 2. And he spake before his brethren and the army of Samaria, and he said, what do these feeble Jews, in other words, what the hell are they doing? Will they fortify themselves? Will they sacrifice? Will they make an end in the day? Will they revive the stones out of the heaps of the rubbish that were burned? Verse 3. Now, Tobiah, the Amorite. Amorite always represents the enemy of God's people. So Tobiah was an Amorite. That tells you right there. He was the chief enemy of God's people. And he was by him. And he said, even that which they built, if a force goes up, it shall break it down. Is that not funny? You are doing a heavy project and somebody comes knocking at you. Look at that. He's trying to build a house. He's trying to build a fence. Even a fox. Can you imagine such a humiliation? Saying that what a whole nation is building, that even if a fox goes and walk on it, it will crumble. That tells you how much he disdained God's people. How much he didn't believe in God's people. He says, even if a fox goes up, he shall even break down their stone wall. Verse 4. Hear, O our God. Now, this is God's people crying out to God. Hear, O our God, for we are despised. And they turn their reproach upon their own head. And give them for a prey in the land of captivity. Verse 5. And cover not their iniquity, and let not their sin be blotted out from before thee. For they have provoked thee to anger before the builders. And look at verse 6. So built we the wall, and all the wall was joined together unto the half thereof. For the people had a mind to walk. In other words, despite the despising of the enemy, despite the fact that the enemy despised them, despite the fact that the enemy didn't believe in them, despite the fact that they mocked them, despite the fact that they thought it was a huge joke, the people had faith in this project. They believed in themselves. They believed in God. They cried out to God. And they had a mind to walk. And they were able to accomplish that project. I've come to tell somebody. I don't know the project you have been working on, maybe for years now. And the enemy have mocked you. If there are things you have been working on, you have set your hands upon to do, to accomplish, and it has become an unfinished project. It has become an unaccomplished project. It has gone on or lingered on for years, maybe. And people have begun to mock you and laugh at you and say, just look at that. He can't even get that done. But this morning, God is saying, your walls are continually before me. Which means your walls are of unfinished projects. Your walls of unaccomplished dreams. Your walls where people have mocked you. The things that have made people to mock you and to laugh at you and to scorn you. God is saying, that wall is continually before me. And I'm doing something about it. And as long as the Lord gave the Israelites, the Jews, he gave them the grace, the strength, the speed, the provision to finish this project despite all the enemy's attacks. I've come to announce to somebody that project you began, that project you've been working on, that project you've been believing God for shall come to pass. It shall come to pass. It shall be fulfilled. It shall be accomplished. It doesn't matter how the enemy doesn't believe. It doesn't matter how the enemy mocks at you. But I declare in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, by the Spirit of the living God, that project shall come to pass. That project shall be fulfilled. That project shall be accomplished. There shall be no more unaccomplished projects. I said there shall be no more unaccomplished projects. Lift your hand and say with me, in the name of Jesus. Say like you mean it, in the name of Jesus. Father, I declare, because I believe your word, you said my walls are before you continually. Therefore, every wall of unfinished has made people mock me. That has made people laugh at me. That has made people scorn me. Today, by the Spirit of God, I receive divine enablement to finish that project. I shall finish my project. I shall finish that project. No more unaccomplished projects. No more unfulfilled projects. No more uncompleted projects in my life, in my destiny, in my finances, in my family. I declare from today, it shall come to pass. It shall come to pass. That dream shall come to pass. That project shall come to pass. That miracle shall come to pass. That healing shall come to pass. I receive, and I believe you, Lord, that it shall come to pass. And I declare over everyone under the sound of my voice, as you receive this word, I prophesy over you now by the Spirit of the Lord, that project you have worked on or you have been working on, that dream that you have been working on, that thing that seems impossible, that has made people laugh at you or scorn you or mock you or not believe in you, I prophesy from now, it shall come to pass. It shall come to pass. It shall come to pass. It shall manifest in the name of Jesus. Amen. Come on, stand on your feet now and begin to declare, according to the word of the Lord, that the wall of unfulfilled dreams, the wall of unfinished projects, the wall of unfinished goals, whatever they are, begin to declare, Father, thank you, because that wall is coming to pass. That project is coming to pass. I receive divine speed to finish that project. I receive divine provisions to finish that project. I receive divine healing to manifest that project. I declare right now that every dream and every goal and every project and every purpose of my heart shall manifest, shall come to pass this month of December and throughout the year 2022. I declare there shall be a manifestation of the promises of God, the manifestation of the dreams, of the project in my life, in the name of Jesus. Magoba sotata, egebeka sotata, rembeka bodo soto, rababazara handaya, lebrekata babazataya, ebo sekete, rabo sekete, ekatama bazata. Come on, declare over your life now. Declare that from now, every unfulfilled dream, every unfinished project, be finished, be fulfilled, be manifested. Begin to declare right now and tell God, Father, every wall before you that represents unfinished projects, unfinished healing miracles, unfinished financial breakthrough, unfinished plans in my life, let them begin to manifest. Let them begin to be fulfilled. Let them be accomplished by the Spirit of the Lord. Between now and the end of this month, between now and the end of this year, between throughout the year 2022, I shall walk in manifested promises. I shall walk in manifested harvest. Pata masota, e kapo shede, Rebecca pavavasa tayaba. Thank you, Lord. Lord, we give you praise. Father, I pray for everyone right now under the sound of my voice. Everyone who have received this word and this message. As you said that our walls are continually before you, I declare that the wall of unfinished project, the wall of unfinished goals, the wall of unaccomplished dreams, whatever those walls are, Father, from today I declare, they shall come to pass. They will begin to manifest. They will begin to come to reality and to fruition by the power of your Spirit in the name of Jesus. Everyone that has mocked your people, everyone that has scorned them, everyone that has made a mockery over any issue, any project, any dream, any goal, anything that was unaccomplished or unfulfilled or unfinished, from now I declare, oh God of heaven, take away the reproach, take away the shame, take away the reproach, take away the shame. Let the enemy be put to shame. Oh God of heaven, give your people the miracle they desire, whatever the miracle. Let there be supernatural testimonies in the name of Jesus. Manifest your promises in the lives of your people. Manifest your glory in the lives of your people. Glorify your name, oh God, in the name of Jesus. And according to your word, I declare, according to the prophetic pronouncement, every obstacle and every limitation that has hindered your people before now, as your word has gone forth, I declare from now, no more limitations, no more obstacles, no more barriers, no more wall of Jericho standing in the way. We walk in to possess our miracles. We walk in to possess our possessions. I speak blessing over your people. I declare breakthrough over your people. Thank you, Lord. And I declare right now that every prayer and every tear and every wailing that has happened that your people have poured out even in the private secret place, Lord, I declare from today that prayer is answered. That tears is wiped away. Wipe away the tear of your people. Hear the cry of your people. Hear the groaning and the weeping of your people. And give them that miracle. Let that miracle manifest in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Come on, begin to thank him now. Just thank him for his prayers. Thank him for the breakthrough. Thank him for the miracle. Thank him for the provisions. This week I declare there shall be supernatural supply. This week I declare miracle money will locate us. This week I declare impossible things become possible. This week I declare obstacles become miracles by the Spirit of God. Pashuta katabasuta rabosheta bosataka. Yay! Kabosata babasata. Thank you, Lord. Just thank you one more time now. Father, we thank you for what you've done. We thank you for what you are doing and what you're about to do. We give you praise. We give you glory. In Jesus' name we pray, and everybody